If you're using an eyelash serum or you're considering using one, you're gonna wanna watch this video. Today, we're gonna talk about Rodan and Field's Lash Boost and whether it's bad for your eyes or not. Before I begin though, I'd like to thank Michelle O, who reached out to me on Facebook and contributed today's question. Now, Michelle, you're probably thinking about Rodan and Field's Lash Boost because you heard in the news that they're facing a potential lawsuit for the ingredient isopropyl clopyrostenate. Isopropyl clopyrostenate belongs to a group of chemicals called prostaglandin analogs. These analogs are similar in the way they function, and they can do some really cool things, like treat glaucoma, a condition where fluid builds up in the front of the eye and potentially damages the optic nerve. So this drug is a good thing for people with glaucoma. Unfortunately, like many drugs, it has side effects, which can be a bad thing.
Side effects may include droopy eyelids, pronounced blood vessels along the eyelid, darkening of the skin on the lids and under the eye, changing the color of the eyes, which doesn't sound bad if it changes my eyes blue, just kidding, tearing, eye pain, cresting, damage to eyesight.
This is how Latisse, a prescription-only drug known for growing eyelashes, came into existence in 2008. Latisse uses a prostaglandin analog called bimatoprost. As a prescription drug, Latisse has to go through rigorous testing to prove it's safe and effective, it has to reveal potentially harmful side effects, and it has to be taken under the supervision of a physician. So does Lash Boost actually work? Yeah! What? A cosmetic that actually does what it claims? Yeah, and that's sort of the problem. According to our friends at the FDA, cosmetics can only cleanse, beautify, promote attractiveness, or alter the appearance. Changing the way your body works so that your lashes actually grow longer, that makes this product a drug, and drugs need to undergo testing for FDA approval. Lash Boost isopropyl clopyrostenate hasn't been submitted for FDA approval like Latisse has. So to answer your question, Michelle, we can't really say it's safe in the same way that we can with other drug products because the ingredient hasn't been tested in the same way. This isn't even the first time isopropyl clopyrostenate appears in an eyelash product. Back in 2011, products Rapid Lash and New Lash tried the same thing and got the smackdown with an FDA warning. New Lash made stronger claims than Lash Boost, but they basically used the same ingredient. So now, some people who've used Lash Boost are claiming to have experienced serious side effects. They even filed a class action lawsuit claiming Rodan and Fields used deceptive labeling, unfair marketing, and failed to disclose the already known side effects that would help consumers balance the benefits with the risks of the product. What I want to know is why the FDA didn't serve Rodan and Fields a warning letter. I also noticed that New Lash hasn't changed one of its formulas and still uses isopropyl clopyrostenate, despite receiving a warning letter. In Lash Boost's defense, just because a drug has side effects doesn't mean you'll experience them. It's like every time you got into a car and you get a warning that you could be going to the grocery store or you could die in some gruesome car accident, without giving you some perspective to the realities of each fate. Rodan and Fields also does have a warning on Lash Boost product page. I'll link to it in the description below so you can check it out. It does cover a lot of ground, but it doesn't specifically mention the more serious side effects. Also, we don't know the actual amount of isopropyl clopyrostenate in the cosmetic, which can increase or decrease the severity of potential side effects. So now that you have an overview of the case and understand some of the risks, my question to you is, would you use Lash Boost? If you found this video informative, please give it a like, and I'll see you in the next video.